Hey everyone, good morning, good evening to the intellectual world of World Wide Web. And today I'm going to discuss about very simple things and very apt in the current scheme of things, where a lot of Indian startups are going hyper-local way. A lot of Indian startups are trying to do things which has already been tested in other countries. However, I think once we understand or once we appreciate the fact, the kind of behaviors which are coming online for the very first time, they are the behaviors which were already existing in the offline media. And I believe the mindset has to change in terms of when we talk about India. India is a country of, you know, 1.3 billion people. Maybe the count is a little bit haywire right now because of the current situation, but just to keep the ball rolling, I'll take it 1.3 billion people. Now, understanding the ecosystem or the landscape of India in terms of startup, let's go back to the year 2007. That time, the word startup never existed. Suddenly, there was an upsurge somewhere between, you know, 2008-2009, when a lot of patent application, a lot of research was going in peer-to-peer node. And that's when the Bitcoin paper also came into picture. And then the whole cryptic world took a, I would say, an escalation. And then a lot of things happened. Many people invested money. Right now, due to the current situation, I think the government of India has taken cognizance of these affairs. And then there's a, you know, there's a period on this. Now the question is how to revive everything in the logical way and to benefit mankind as such. I remember when I started my first company as an LLP, that was in the year 2010. At the same point of time, Snapdeal also came into existence, and suddenly, you know, Snapdeal growth at that point of time was an upsurge. It was a totally, I would say, it was going very smart way, and it was going up because you could see their banners at the airports, you could see their banners in different malls, and there was a lot of investment in Snapdeal. Over the years, these companies and other companies, whether it's Flipkart, whether it's Foodiebay, which was renamed as Zomato, or whether it's Make My Trip, which is seeing a different kind of ball game altogether, because obviously most of the employees of Make My Trip were working from home for quite a long. It's not that they started working from home during this COVID period, but they were working from home for quite a long time, because I understand as a consumer, when I was a consumer of Make My Trip, I understood how they were working and what were the ethics with which they were trying to understand the customers. In India, we say customer is king. I would say in the business world, customer can be a king, queen, prince, princess, whatever suits the, you know, consumer. But customer can be not only the king, but it's the queen and other concept. The point I'm trying to make here is when we talk about online behavior, because I myself, we are, apart from my core work of IPR, we have been developing this product which is based on AI ML, and which is also catering to the AR VR community at large, because I believe product launch has to be at the right time. I think when the product launch is at the right time, that is the time you can escalate the business. I would say the pivot is, it's not a pivot, but you escalate. And when you escalate at the same point of time, you need to branch out. Never put all your eggs in one basket. Everybody knows about this concept. So if the business model is that golden goose model, I would rather branch out and see that all the branches are working in the right direction. At least they are aiming and they are aligning with the goals. And I've been very vocal about SDG goal number 17, which talks about partnerships. Now the point is, many a times when we are talking about the service industry, in the service industry, there is no warehousing, but yes, there is warehousing in the mind of the person who is actually providing that service or that consultancy. A few days back, something on my wall just popped out, like when a trader is selling the same thing, a trader will say the margin of profit will keep minimum, but they will try and sell in quantity, not in quality. That's in quantity. So say for example, something is being sold in the market for INR 108 and the basic cost comes around 55, INR 55. And even if somebody is able to double it up, that comes to 110 INR. And when you add up those numbers, then you know that you keep the minimum margin and then you build on quantity. However, I believe in the online world, I don't believe in the influencer concept. At least I don't believe, because I believe the kind of services we provide, intellectual property rights, the world, the global world is working on IPR. US is superpower because of IPR. All the presidents, all the ministers, all the people, since I think if you just walk through the videos in the online media, and especially in the YouTube, you will see everybody has been talking about intellectual property rights. However, the question still which needs to be answered by the Indian fraternity is, do they understand intellectual property rights? Just filing a trademark or a design application or a patent application will get them that zillion dollar funding? And even if you have the funds, what are you going to do with the funds? I think that's the question each entrepreneur needs to answer. So even before answering those questions, so the newbies, for the very first time, there's so much in the online world which is absolutely, which is said, you know, F-R-E-E. Why don't you use it? Build something and see, the best of the parties will come for you. The only thing is, the zeal has to be there, the intent has to be there, and the youth has to work. Youth should not be in a position stating the fact that, you know, the same way where US people have been stating, or maybe I haven't seen the Europeans stating this concept where they say, you know, we want to take a break after 35. So many times I would say in many aspects in this period itself, many people would be having money. So I think they got that break, whatever they thought they needed in this time of the hour. So the point is, when the offline behavior is being mimicked in the online world, there has to be tweak, because it's not that the offline behavior are the right behaviors. The idea of coming online is to bridge the digital divide, leaving no one behind, and appreciating the fact that protection laws have to be there for child, adult and senior. These are the, I would say, the mool mantra or the main phase which each one of us has to recognize, breathe on that thought process, and then only, you know, you will be able to unbundle and bucket the stuff. The other point is, never put a mark on that, okay, if you're providing a service, this is what I want to charge. See the bigger picture, because I believe when you are able to dream the biggest picture possible with your imagination, that's when, you know, the reality becomes fun. Why I say so? Because when I started off intellectual property rights in my career, I was given a choice where there were some people in the industry who stated, you know, we will provide you these facilities, blah, 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 blah. And then when we talk about the monetary gain, it's like, you know, you are giving peanuts. And I was like, no way, I'm not going to take a penny from my parents. Whatever I have to do, I have to do it on my own. And this is not going to, you know, provide me the lifestyle I wish to live. So that was my intent at that point of time. I'm talking way back in 2007. And the power to say no in those years, not only in 2007, I have said no in 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009, every year. There are a couple of situations where I take that decision, the power to say no. I think the power to say no switch ons if you just, you know, if you see that word O-N, if you read it the other way around, no becomes on. Let's switch on that another realm of thinking, where don't put a cap on, you know, the costing, that this is the cost the consumer should pay. Think the bigger picture. The bigger picture you see, that's when, you know, those thoughts, those ideas will come into reality, where you can code your product, your services in a way where it's a win-win for everyone. Let's celebrate SDG goal number 17, and I invite everyone to attend our cybersecurity drill webinar, which is happening on 6th of October 2020 in the online meetup. Have a great day ahead. Bye-bye.